हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम बिंदु त्रिखा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर आई एम एस गाजियाबाद। टुडे वी वुड बी डिस्कसिंग डिफरेंस बिटवीन प्रोसीजरल प्रोग्रामिंग एंड ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग वाया अ स्टोरी। दिस इज अ स्टोरी अबाउट ऑफ टू प्रोग्रामर्स। वन प्रोग्रामर इज टोटली is totally dependent on the procedural programming, and the other programmer is somewhat flexible and is using object-oriented programming. Let's see how the story goes. We have two programmers. One is Samir and second is Tanya. One day, they both were given the same specifications and were told to build an application. The specifications were, they have to create three shapes. They were given three shapes: a square, a circle, and a triangle. The problem was, when the user clicks on any of the shapes, the shape will rotate 360 degree, and a particular sound would be played when the shape rotates. Samir was a procedural programming guy, and he thought, what are the procedures do we need? The procedures, as implied by the specifications, were the rotate and the play sound. Since procedural programmers are focused only on the procedures, so he thought the program is a collection of procedures, and I would have to implement a rotate function and a play sound function. Now Tanya believes in object-oriented programming. She thought, who are the key players? What is the main thing in this particular program? What I mainly need? The shapes. Yes, she thought of user, sound, and event, clicking event functions also, but she had the library codes for all these, so she concentrated only on the shapes. Procedural programming guy Samir wrote rotate and sound in no time. The function, there was one function named rotate. It makes the shape rotate 360 degrees, and play sound. It would play a .wav file for this particular sound. Provided shape number was given to him. In object-oriented programming, Tanya wrote three classes for different shapes: for square, for circle, and for triangle. For square, she wrote a rotate function and a play sound function. Similarly, for circle as well as for triangle. Samir thought, wow, I have nailed it and have completed the work in much less time as compared to Tanya. But suddenly, then the manager said, I have changed certain specifications. Specifications are, a new shape is added, amoeba. Amoeba is, everybody knows, it's a distorted shape that doesn't have any particular angle or a side, or it's not a circle. It is distorted shape basically. When the user clicks on the amoeba, the shape will rotate 360 degrees. And rather than .wav file for shape number 1, 2 and 3, it should play a .mp3 file. Okay. Samir said, I can complete it quickly as the Oracle Tanya is too slow. Since it had to rotate it using a 360 degree rotation, he kept the rotate function as it is and the play sound function was changed. The change was, if the shape is not amoeba, dot web file should be played, and if it is amoeba, then dot mp3 file should be changed. What Tanya did, she already had three classes. She wrote a new class named amoeba, and in that, the rotate function, we had the code to rotate the amoeba, and in play sound, she took a .mp3 file to be played. Samir had to make the changes in the previously tested code and will have to do so every time the specification changes. Just have a look at it. His play sound function in previous program without amoeba shape were these, that he had to play only the web file. But as soon as the manager changed the technical specifications, he had to change his play sound function. And next time, if there are certain more changes, he would have to change the code again. On the contrary, Tanya just wrote a new class and did not made any change in the previously tested code, because she had already tested classes square, triangle and circle. In procedural programming, lot of code was affected. Previously tested codes needs to be changed or need to be retested. And what if the specifications change again? Then he'll have to change the functions again. In object-oriented programming, on the other hand, Tanya only added a new class named amoeba with the new functions. Now, there was one more issue, that was the major implementation issue. For rotating the shape 360 degrees, the logic that was being implemented was, determine the rectangle that surrounds the shape, calculate the center, and then rotate this particular figure corresponding to this central position. And for amoeba, the client wanted that rather than taking the central position as the point of reference, the edge of the amoeba should be used to rotate the figure to 360 degrees. In procedural approach, Samir had to change the rotate function as well as previously he had changed the play sound function. That means the whole program is changed. Whereas Tanya had just to change the amoeba class. The rotate function that was being implemented in amoeba class was required to be changed. Which approach is more efficient? Changing one class or editing the entire file? Obviously, changing one class is much more easier than the procedural approach. Now, Samir came. Wait, Tanya, you have duplicated the code. You have rotate procedure and play sound procedure for all the four shapes. Tanya said, it's a method, not procedure, and these are classes, not things. Let me explain you. What she explained, that we have a class named square, we have a class named circle, we have a class named triangle. Herein, the code for rotate and play sounds are almost the same, because these are being rotated 360 degrees with reference to the central position, and for play sound we have dot web file. In case of amoeba class, we have written a code amoeba to rotate it using the points x and y, and the play sound function was used to play the .mp3 file. Here, what the classes have in common? Rotate and play sound. So, design the base class first. Let the name of the class be shape. Herein we have added the common features, that is rotate and the play sound function, with the common features that are being implemented for class square, circle and the triangle. And I have declared four derived classes: amoeba, triangle, rectangle and square. All these classes would be inheriting the features of the class shape. That is, she did not have to rewrite the function again. Only the shapes would be inheriting the features from the base class. Then Samir again interrupted, what about amoeba? It had completely different rotate and play sound procedures. Tanya said, no worries. Now I have triangle, rectangle and square with the shapes, with the functions, rotate and play sound. Common functions I have for all the three. For amoeba, I have written a specific code, that is amoeba specific code, and for rotate and play sound functions. This feature is known as overwriting. Overwriting means the derived class can redefine its own functions if the code needs to be changed. Otherwise, the previously declared functions can be used as it is by the derived classes. When it's time for triangle to rotate, the program code invokes the rotate method on the triangle object. And when you need to add any new shape, just you have to add the class for it specifying its behavior. Thus, Tanya won the challenge and was the winner of the coding program. And obviously, the procedural oriented programming is much behind object oriented programming in terms of code reusability, in terms of less efforts in building new code, in terms of easy maintenance, and obviously it has a number of new features that are not available in POP language. Thank you and have a nice day.